When fighting erupted in Sudan, Rosa Yusuf Elias escaped on foot with her 7 children over the border to her homeland, South Sudan, where she thought they would be safe. Instead, they've been stranded for weeks in an isolated camp that has been overwhelmed by the sudden arrival of tens of thousands of people fleeing the violence next door. I've spent 45 days here. The environment is full of flies, snakes, and no good food. Our children are not used to the kind of food provided here, and some have developed diarrhea. And in the last few days, we've lost 3 children in this camp. The environment is very bad. The influx adds to an already dire situation in South Sudan, a troubled country that has struggled with war, famine, and natural disaster since gaining independence from Sudan in 2011. Those arriving have turned to aid groups already under strain trying to provide basic services in a country where 2/3 of the population rely on humanitarian assistance to survive. The scene near the border is grim, with children suffering malnutrition, tensions over limited resources, and families sleeping in the open as the camp's population climbs by the day. My family's situation in Khartoum is desperate. We ran from there because the situation is very bad. There's no water, no electricity, and even no food because there are no jobs. That is why we are appealing to our relatives who are part of the diaspora and to our government to support us and bring those who remain behind back home here. The UN Refugee Agency, UNHCR, says over 100,000 people have crossed from Sudan since fighting there began about 2 months ago, an average of more than 1,000 per day. Children have been particularly affected, dehydrated and malnourished after the long journey overland through harsh country. The UN's World Food Programme and other aid groups operating at the camp are stretched to capacity and warn things could get worse as more people arrive.
We see increase, and the average data that we could talk about is that in each day we are able to get 1,000 and above. So the range is from 1,000 and above individual crossing to South Sudan through Jodah border. So that is the maximum, meaning the minimum average.
Many wish to leave the camp, but Renk, the nearest town, lies in a remote northeastern part of South Sudan without roads, where floods and armed insecurity pose very real threats to safety.
The cases, it is the children are severe. They are severely minority, and I think so. What caused all these things? Maybe the suffering from, because people they've been here 3 days, 4 days on the way to coming here, without food, sometimes with the lack of water, sometimes the water is not treated well. This caused a lot of rehydration. So those things we receive these cases.
Prices for basic goods have skyrocketed in local markets due to the influx.
A place does not have enough capacity to facilitate the people, and with the rain season we can expect a lot of problems, including diseases like cholera because of the poor environment, and also the malnutrition levels could rise, but also the diseases like diarrhea and all that. So there is need to get funds and provide the necessary services in health facilities.
More than 800,000 South Sudanese were living in Sudan when the conflict broke out. Many were refugees from the decades-long struggle for liberation and more recently, a devastating civil war that erupted in the south shortly after independence. They returned to a country still wracked by the armed violence and ethnic strife they fled, and scarred by 4 consecutive years of record flooding.